It may not seem like it right now, but finding the area of shapes, especially composite figures, will be a valuable skill to have later on in life. One day, you may decide that you want to repaint the walls in your house or put in new carpet. And yes, there are companies and people we can hire to do this for us. However, you will want to know the area of the walls that are being painted and the amount of carpet needed so that you know how much you will be charged. Or you may want to take on the project and do it yourself. And you may have not noticed, but walls and rooms can come in all shapes and sizes. In this video, you will learn how to find the area of a composite figure. Let's look at an example. Notice the shape below is made up of three different shapes, one square and two different triangles. When a shape is made up of more than one shape, we can call that a composite figure. To find the total area of this composite figure, we will start by breaking the shape up into three different pieces so that you can find the area of each piece. Then we can add the area of each shape together to get the total area. Let's start with the square. Recall the formula we used to find the area of a square, A equals S squared. You can see that the base and the right side of the square are labeled as 12 feet, which means that we can plug in 12 to the S in our formula. Now we will have A equals 12 squared. At this point, we can multiply 12 by 12, which gives us 144. The square has an area of 144 feet squared. Now that we have found the area of the square, let's find the area of the triangle that is sitting on top of the square. The formula to find the area of a triangle is A equals half base times height, or A equals base times height divided by 2. The base of the triangle is 12, but the height, which is measured from the base to the tip-top point of the triangle, is not labeled. However, we have been provided some information to help us determine the height. We know that the bottom of the square to the top of the triangle is 20 feet. We also know that the square is 12 feet tall, which means the difference between 20 and 12 would be the height of the triangle. If we find the difference of 20 and 12, we will see that the height of the triangle equals 8 feet. We need to plug in 12 and 8 into our formula, so now we have A equals 12 times 8 divided by 2. Now we can solve. 12 times 8 equals 96, and 96 divided by 2 equals 48. The area of the triangle on top of the square is equal to 48 feet squared. The last shape that we need to find the area of is the triangle on the side of the square. This triangle's base is shared with the right side of the square, which is labeled as 12 feet. There is a dotted line stretching from the middle of the base to the top of the triangle, and it is labeled as 8 feet. We will use the same area formula, A equals base times height divided by 2, and plug in the measurements for each. We now have A equals 12 times 8 divided by 2. Now we can start calculating the area. 12 times 8 equals 96, and 96 divided by 2 equals 48. The area of this triangle is 48 feet squared, which was the same area as the other triangle. The last thing that we need to do is to add the areas of each shape so that we can calculate the total area of the composite figure. We found that the square had an area of 144 feet squared, and both triangles have an area of 48 feet squared. If we add 144 plus 48 plus 48, we will get a sum of 240 feet squared. And this is the area of our composite shape.